Let us talk about who is a startup entrepreneur. I've often been asked this question, so I thought let me try and cover this in a separate episode. The Oxford Dictionary defines the word entrepreneur as a person who sets up a business or businesses, taking on financial risks in the hope of making a profit. So then, just who is a startup entrepreneur? In a broad overall sense, an entrepreneur is a person who, one, organizes a business venture and assumes the complete risk for the venture, at times giving his personal guarantees and taking personal liabilities. Number two, is a person who has looked at a problem and seen it as an opportunity. They should then develop on this opportunity to start something new, with the intention of generating surpluses for themselves or their investors. Number three, have a fire in their belly to do something that feels that their ambition is being held in check by corporate red tape or other types of bureaucracy. Though it takes more than just cleverness and frustration with the status quo to get an entrepreneurial venture off the ground. And finally, an entrepreneur is a person who assumes the financial risk of the initiation, operation, and management of the business. These are just four points that have been there in my own mind since I became an entrepreneur 20 years ago. I've also believed most entrepreneurs are driven not by the need to make money, but by the need to make their dreams a reality. I've also said very often that if you're a startup entrepreneur, do what you want to do, which is your dream, and your valuations and your profits and your money will follow. Entrepreneurs are driven by their passion to implement their ideas and see these ideas succeed. The higher the energy of the entrepreneur, driven by passion, is what is needed to provide the leadership to a team of people and to make the opportunity work in a challenging environment. More often than not, money is a byproduct of an entrepreneur's motivation rather than the motivation itself. Entrepreneurs are participants, not observers. They are players, not fans. And to be an entrepreneur is to be an optimist, to believe that with the right amount of time and money, you can achieve anything. When an entrepreneur reaches an obstacle, they turn it into an opportunity. Every entrepreneur does not have to be the initiator of a new idea. He or she is the person who helps in implementation of the idea and to build it into a successful commercial enterprise. Failure is essential for any new entrepreneur to succeed. Entrepreneurs cannot let any adversity pull them back. They have to learn from their mistakes and their adversities, accept the knockout that can happen in their profit and loss account, and they need to keep moving ahead. Looking back is not an answer. Looking ahead is the only answer. Every entrepreneur has to plan for the best, but prepare for the worst. It is often said that there is an aha moment or a eureka moment in the life of an entrepreneur when suddenly something dramatic happens and a brilliant idea surfaces. I have seldom come across a eureka moment in the life of any entrepreneur. What entrepreneurs build is based on their grit, determination, hard work, and a lot of professional and personal sacrifice. An entrepreneur's gut feeling, which leads them to take tough decisions, is often the subject of a lot of discussion. And my own learning here has been that gut feel is really the extract of all their experience and one's ability for risk taking rather than some vision that an entrepreneur purportedly has had. Remember, vision is something that you start with for your business. It is not a dream that will help you to change the course or direction of your business. Contrary to popular belief, entrepreneurs are not generally high risk takers when they cannot affect the outcome of the situation. They tend to set realistic and achievable goals, and when they do take risks, they are usually calculated ones based on facts and experience rather than simply on instincts. Every entrepreneur goes through a lot of soul searching, goes through a lot of introspection before they take any tough decisions that is going to impact not only their business, not only their investment, but also the thousands of people who are directly or indirectly connected to their venture. If one is convinced about an idea, there is no better time than now to start your entrepreneurial journey. The choice is yours and yours alone. Refuse to throw in the towel. Go that extra mile that failures refuse to travel. It is far better to be exhausted from success than to be rested from failure. Building a new company is very hard work. The hardest part of building a new company is not coming up with a new idea, but to stay committed to your dream when you are dead tired or when you have to tell your spouse that you cannot go for a party because your work needs you more. If a person is not willing to give up on things really important to oneself, or if you are likely to be put down because of a rejection, it will be very difficult to stick to and implement your idea. The proverbial buck stops at the desk of the entrepreneur. I also have a book titled The Buck Stops Here. The entrepreneur is the person who has to find the money at the end of each month to pay salaries and other operating costs, most often sacrificing their own comforts and drawing no salary till the company starts to make an operating surplus or a profit. As CEOs of large companies, I've often heard from many people say that the buck stops with them. And I tell them that the buck stops not with someone who has to take the last decision, but for someone who has to find money at the end of every month to pay salaries. Because many, many people are dependent on the salary that is being paid to them out of the entrepreneurial venture. As someone said, a child today can expect to change jobs at least 7 times over the course of their lives. And 5 of those jobs don't exist yet. You never know if your dream enterprise will be one of the many new job creators in the world. Your entrepreneurial journey could be a game changer, could be a world changer. There has never been a better time to build your own enterprise. Every country, every government is encouraging startups and entrepreneurship. Take the plunge, start your planning process now. There is no day as good as today to make a beginning if you genuinely believe in your dream. Good luck and all the best in your entrepreneurial journey.
Thank you for listening to The Brand Called You videocast and podcast, a platform that brings you knowledge, experience and wisdom of hundreds of successful individuals from around the world. Do visit our website www.tbcy.in to watch and listen to the stories of many more individuals. You can also follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. Just search for The Brand Called You.